In this video, I'm talking about using your Apple AirPods Pro as hearing aids. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. All I can say is it is about time, because for years, individuals have speculated as to whether or not Apple would actually get into the hearable or the hearing aid space. Well, that time has finally come. I, for one, did not think that Apple would actually get into the hearing aid space. And the reason I felt that wasn't because Apple isn't capable of actually developing a product that could be used by individuals with hearing loss, but because the hearing loss market is so stinking small compared to the mass appeal that they have with regular consumer products. However, with all of the focus that Apple has placed on the health features inside of their products, along with the fact that Apple really has been working alongside hearing aid manufacturers for a number of years now with their made for iPhone hearing aids, and then you combine that with the fact that there are millions upon millions of individuals across the world who have hearing loss that need some help, it really seems like Apple is on a mission. Well, the word is that the new iOS 14 update is actually going to allow the AirPods Pro to act more like a hearing aid, meaning they're actually going to be able to take some external sounds and amplify them for you if you need a little bit of a boost. You can already use a feature called Live Listen Mode, which is where you actually take your iPhone, you turn on Live Listen Mode, and you either hand it to someone else to talk into, or you set it in front of them, and this acts like a remote microphone that sends their voice directly into your device, so you can cut out a lot of different background noise and actually increase the volume of their voice. But the new iOS update is supposed to allow your AirPods Pro to increase your environmental sounds without having to have all of those sounds go through the microphone of your iPhone. So you'll be able to actually keep your iPhone in your pocket. You don't have to hand it to someone for them to talk into, and you should be able to boost the volume around you. When it comes to customizing the amount of amplification that you will receive with your AirPods Pro, we don't know what that is actually going to look like yet, but we suspect that you're going to be able to actually upload a custom audiogram like you can get with the Mimi Hearing Test app, which is actually the same type of hearing test that I took to customize my Broggy Dash Pro earbuds. In fact, I've already taken my Mimi Hearing Test and have uploaded it into my iPhone in preparation for when iOS 14 is released. Ultimately, what will the actual capabilities be of the AirPods Pro as hearing aids? And we don't really know the answer to that yet. I suspect that Apple will do a couple of things really well, but I also expect them to miss the boat on a variety of different important factors. There are still a lot of questions that we do not know the answers to. I mean, how much customization will we actually be able to do with the AirPods Pro from an amplification perspective? Will the amplification actually meet real ear measurement prescriptive targets? Will the occlusion effect still be a problem even when you're in transparency mode, which is a huge issue that I find, and in fact is the reason that I'm not wearing both of them right now recording this video. Of course, they'll probably still suffer from very short battery life if you're going to be using these devices throughout the course of the day as actual hearing aids. You are not going to be getting more than a couple hours worth of battery life at a time. A big question is, what will the processing delay be like? So will all of the processing actually happen inside of the AirPods, or will some of that processing have to be done on the iPhone? If it's done on the iPhone, that means that the device has to pick up the audio, send it to the iPhone for processing, and then from the iPhone it has to go back to the AirPod to actually amplify that sound inside of your ear. If they can do all of this really quick, like within several milliseconds, then it's not going to be a problem at all. But I have a suspicion that there might be a little bit of an audio delay if that sound has to be processed on the actual iPhone. And the biggest question of them all is, will they actually be able to function well in a background noise setting? I know that they get a lot of fanfare for this active noise cancellation, but it's really easy to cancel out extraneous sound when you're just trying to stream audio in from a device. But when you're trying to separate speech from background noise, that becomes significantly more difficult to do, and who knows whether or not the AirPods Pro will be able to actually do that. Each one of the answers to these questions will ultimately be make it or break it factors when it comes to using these guys as actual hearing aids. So if you're interested in seeing my detailed review of the Apple AirPods Pro to be used as hearing aids, then make sure you stay tuned to my channel, because as soon as the iOS 14 update comes out, I'm gonna jump into this review so I can answer all of these questions and more. And as soon as I'm done with that review, I will also link it in the description of this video. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.